Good afternoon, dear students. So now we are going to start the topic figure of speech. It plays a very important role. In language, without figure of speech, we can't imagine the beauty of the language. As we are in need to decorate ourselves, to adorn ourselves, to show, to impress someone else, in the same way to beautify our language, to beautify our tongue, we use figure of speech. So, first is simile. In Hindi, it is called as upma, upma alankar. In simile, it is a comparison between two different objects. Between two different objects, but which have at least one point in common. At least one point in common. That is known as simile. For example, life is like a dream. Life is like a dream. So we have compared life to a dream, and to show this connectivity, we use like. So whenever we have come to know how to recognize figure of speech in a sentence, if you notice like, so, as in any sentence, that is for simile. Like, so, as. It is used for simile. Second one is metaphor. It is called in Hindi Rupak Alankar. In it is an implied simile. Words of comparison are not used, means it is same to same, same as simile, but the words of comparison like, so, as are not used there. For example, Shivaji was a tiger. Life is a dream. Here we consider that Shivaji was a tiger, means tiger denotes for the courageousness, boldness, and life is a dream, not like a dream. That's a metaphor between upma and rupa. This is the common difference. Third one is personification. Personification. In this figure of speech, lifeless objects and abstract ideas are thought as living being. Personification means manvikaran alankar. Lifeless objects, for example, marker, specs, mobile phone, TV. Abstract ideas means thought, feelings, emotions, they are abstract ideas. All of them are considered as a living being. So, it is called personification. For example, love is blind. Love is an abstract idea, it's only thought. And blind means the person who has life, who is a living being. Because only living being can be blind, but love is an abstract idea, but it is considered as living being, so that's why it is the example of personification. Next is experience is the best teacher. Teacher is a living being, But experience, that is only thought, only our thinking. But we are considering it as living being. So that's why it is another example of personification. In poetry, the poets always imagine moon as a symbol of beauty. So they are always symbolized or personified such natural things as living being. In Ramayana, you have seen when Mother Sita is stolen or kidnapped by Ravan, Ram and Lakshman both are calling for the natural things. O forest, O pushpa, O nadi, O vayu. They are addressing all the things. For what? Have you seen Mother Sita? Have you seen Sita anywhere else? They are addressing because they are considering them as a living being. That is an example of personification. Next is apostrophe. Apostrophe means sambodhan. Here we address to a dead person. We address a dead person or personified object. Personified object as we consider they are living being. For example, O death, why are you so cruel? Why are you so cruel? In the same way, O world, my world, I know I come. Means addressing of such things, those are personified of dead person. And easily it is can be recognized by this mark, apostrophe mark or exclamation mark. It can be identified in a sentence. Next is hyperbole. In Hindi, it is known as atishyokti alankar. Atishyokti means exaggeration. When we exaggerate our feelings, our emotions, or anything we exaggerate, that is called hyperbole. For example, she wept oceans of tears. वो इतना रोई कि आंसुओं का सागर बन गया. It is never possible. It is the example of exaggeration because we are exaggerating the thing. Tears कभी भी इतने अमाउंट नहीं हो सकते कि सागर बना ले. सागर बहुत दूर की बात है, एक बाउल भी नहीं हो सकता ना. तो ये एग्जाम्पल है हाइपरबोल, अतिशयोक्ति का. नेक्स्ट इज ऑक्सीमोरन. ऑक्सीमोरन मीन्स विरोधाभास अलंकार. इन दिस फिगर ऑफ स्पीच टू अपोजिट आइडियाज आर पुट टूगेदर. टू अपोजिट आइडियाज आर पुट टूगेदर. For example, life is a bitter sweet. Bitter and sweet, both are opposites. So, he is the wisest fool. He is the wisest fool. Wisest, most intelligent person, and fool, no better. So both are the example of oxymoron, means virodhabhas alankar. Next is onomatopoeia. Onomatopoeia means dhvani alankar. In this figure of speech, the sound of the words suggests the sense of meaning. Only on the basis of sound. For whatsoever, if you are in your house at night or in daytime, you hear someone barking out of the door,
only by hearing that object you can identify easily that is dog, that is cat, and at night you are sleeping and you hear some mysterious sound in your kitchen and you just say, what you call, there is a mouse in the kitchen. So where we can justify, we can recognize presence of an object by hearing only a sound, that is onomatopoeia. For example, the dogs bark. Bark is the example of mews, meow. That is example of, yeah, a cat is present there. Roaring, that's soundproof. There is a tiger in a zoo. So this is the example of onomatopoeia. Next is, alliteration. Repetition of letters. Repetition of letters is known as alliteration. That's an example of alliteration. For example, hurt hands, H and H, both are repetition of a letter, that is known as alliteration. So these are the examples of your figure of speech.